Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, as you might be aware of the fact that we also have a series in which what we do, we daily discuss some questions for the purpose of prelims 2020. So we have named this series that is let's cover some questions for prelims 2020. So as is clear from its name, so the purpose is not just to solve the questions or cover the questions, but it is also to ensure your participation, active participation in the discussion. So if you have any additional information, any extra information relating to the questions that are discussed, then you are more than welcome to comment in the comment box so that other people can also learn, and in this way a healthy community can be built by discussing the questions and the important concepts. So today is video number 11. We are going to cover video number 11 of this. So and we are discussing we will be discussing the questions from modern India in this video. So first question is, who among the following is associated with Atmiya Sabha? A. Bal Gangadhar Tilak, B. Raja Ram Mohan Roy, C. Mahadev Govind Rana Day, D. Swami Vivekanand. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is B, that is Raja Ram Mohan Roy. He was associated with Atmiya Sabha. Atmiya Sabha, he founded this Sabha in 1814. So Raja Ram Mohan Roy came and settled in Calcutta, and in 1815 he founded this Atmiya Sabha, not in 1814. So it was an association for the dissemination of religious truth and the promotion of free discussions of theological subjects. So here recital and expounding of Hindu scriptures were done, so option B is correct. So Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Rana Day are associated with Pune Sarvajanik Sabha. So this is also important because not just the correct answer is important, but you must also be knowing that which other personalities are given in the option and in with which organization they were associated. So Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Mahadev Govind Rana Day were associated with Pune Sarvajanik Sabha, and Swami Vivekanand was associated with Ramakrishna Mission. So this is the answer of first question. Let's move to the second question. Next is, consider the following about Pune Sarvajanik Sabha. First, it was established by Ganesh Vasudeo. Second, it acted as a mediating body between the government and people of India. Third, it advocated the principle of Swadeshi and Swaraj. So we have to choose the correct answer using the codes below. So let me tell you friends, we have to choose that which of these is correct. First is correct. Yeah, it was established by Ganesh Vasudeo, and M.G. Rana Day was also associated with it, and then there was one more personality, I'm not able to recall his name, and then Bal Gangadhar Tilak was also associated with it, and it acted as a mediating body between the government and the people of India. But let me tell you friends that it didn't advocated such radical things like Swadeshi and Swaraj. So they are the things that emerged in the beginning of 20th century. So answer is A, 1 and 2. It was established by M.G. Rana Day in 1870 along with Ganesh Vasudeo and others, for example S.H. Siplankar. And then Bal Gangadhar Tilak was also associated with it. So its main purpose was to act as the mediating body between government and people of India. So it was an elected body of 95 members elected by 6,000 persons in 1870. So this was a kind of a precursor to Indian National Congress, whose first session was itself organized in Maharashtra. So it provided Pune Sarvajanik Sabha provided prominent leaders that were of national stature to the Indian freedom struggle, including Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, the subsidiary alliance was a system of A. Economic partnership between the Indian states and the British, political and military agreement between Indian states and the British, agreements between European traders regarding the economic division of Indian states, D. Treaties that restricted the inheritance rights of rulers in Indian states. So we have to choose that which of these is correct. Let me tell you friends that option C is correct. So subsidiary alliance was a kind of a system. Here option C is not correct. Option B is correct. So it was a kind of system in which the princes came into political and military agreement with the British, that is East India Company. So it was a kind of the British company had to act as a kind of protectorate of these protector of these princely states. So there was there is more detail about subsidiary lands which can't be discussed here, but a little bit introduction can be given. So according to the terms, Indian rulers were not allowed to have their independent armed forces. So they were to be protected by the company and had to pay for the subsidiary force that the company would maintain for the purpose of the protection of the princely states. That is, in simple words, the princes were required to pay a certain sum of amount for the forces which were not there, but were maintained by company for them. So this was a major blow. In fact, a king can't be a king if he or she doesn't have his own force. So that was a kind of thing. And also then, if the Indian rulers failed to make payment, so part of their territory was taken away as penalty. So for example, Richard Wellesley was Governor General 1798 to 1805. So Nawab of Awadh was forced to give over half of his territory to the company in 1801 as he failed to pay for the subsidiary forces. And then Hyderabad was also forced to cede territories on similar ground. So this is your question. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, the Satnami movement in central India was related to A, fighting for social justice for marginalized castes and communities; B, organized rebellion against the British government to recapture croplands; C, a revivalist movement calling for return to ancient Hinduism; D, stopping the practice of sati and widow prosecution in rural India. So friends, the answer is A, that is fighting for social justice for marginalized castes and communities. So Ghasi Das was the person who established this Satnami community in Chhattisgarh, India. So based on Satnam, that means truth and equality. So he instigated a social religious order that discarded and helped in demolishing the hierarchical caste system from the society. So this new order, basically the principle of it was to treat all people equal. So it Satnami principle stated that there is only one God and who is formless and infinite. And then the view of its founder, that is Ghasi Das, was that measures to eradicate social injustice and disparity would stay insufficient and unfinished unless the proper transformation of an individual take place. So these are the four questions that we discussed today. So if you liked these questions, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends. And lastly, friends, one more thing I want to say, that if you have scored three out of five or four or five out of five, then it is good. But if you have scored 0, 1, 2, then it is best, because at least you have learned something today. So you have gained something, and your time is not wasted. So there is no need to worry about it that you are not able to solve the questions, because at least you have learned something, and that what matters is the progress. So no matter how do you progress, but the progress matters. So do ensure that you daily watch this video, these videos. We post two videos relating to it, and at least 10 MCQs are discussed daily. So we have nearly 6 months for prelims, and then daily if we discussed 10 MCQs, then obviously close to 1800 MCQs will be covered. So that is a kind of a comprehensive preparation, if you see. So don't ignore these videos just for the sake that you don't know the answers. And also, friends, if you are interested in our polity series, we have started Indian polity series by M. Lakshmikant, and we are covering the entire book in 60 days. So we have kept a fee of just ₹249 for it. So you will be daily given a target to read, and in the evening you will get 10 MCQs from the given target. So thus, in the entire book will be covered in 60 days, and you will get 600 MCQs based on entire book at the end of this series, and that will be in a single PDF document. So that would be a kind of a handy document with you, which you people can use for revising important concepts that are important for your CSE preparation, that are also important in Lakshmikant book. So if you are interested, then do ensure that you check the description box, because this link which is shown on your screen, this is provided in the description box. So if in case you are interested to join, then do ensure that you check the Telegram the description box. And lastly, friends, we also have a Telegram channel where we have more than 50 14,000 subscribers. So these subscribers have access to various public resources that we post on our Telegram account. And these resources, for example, the PDF of this discussion will also be uploaded there in that Telegram channel. So if in case you are interested to get the PDF and want to get access to various public resources that we share for the purpose of CSE preparation, then do ensure that you join our Telegram channel, the link of which is in description box. So friends, this is all about today's discussion. If you liked it, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you friends, have a very nice day.